one of the ways that Donald Trump and his team have attempted to spin his flight from Lesley Stahl is that Lesley Stahl, in the end, she had to acknowledge how awesome he was. Here's an example of that. Trump tweeted this: Kayleigh McEnany presenting Lesley Stahl with some of the many things we've done for healthcare. Lesley had no idea. And that is Kayleigh McEnany hefting not her normal binder of answers, but supposedly a book filled up with all of what they've done for healthcare. Not their healthcare plan, mind you. You will never, ever, ever see that. But they did get this book. But here's the cell phone in it. If you zoom into that last photo, this is the latest in a long string of blank pieces of paper. Like, you can see that. Like, okay, I understand in books, the first couple of pages might be blank. She's a chunk of the way in there. I don't see anything on that page. I just don't.
No, are they serious with this? I'm trying to see the picture. That really is, that's a really big book, first of all. And they clearly have not accomplished that many things in on healthcare, let alone the fact that they have absolutely no plan for us. Has Lesley Stahl confirmed that she said that this was awesome, or is this just another thing that he's just throwing out and trying to make it true? Because
I haven't seen her talk at all about it. This is all the way Kayleigh and Trump have talked about that interaction.
And my last thing about this is, have they like officially cleared Kayleigh McEnany and all of the White House staff that were infected with COVID-19? Because I don't see a single mask in it. And I'm a little far away from my monitor. Maybe there is a mask and I just can't see it.
I didn't see a mask. I assume it's been a bit. She seems healthy enough. Trump, I'm sure, has mostly recovered, although he had an interview, I think, with Fox and Friends a day ago.
Oh, yeah.
Or 2 days ago, where he didn't sound great, man. I don't know. If I sounded like that, I would take a half day.
Take a day
I
off, think.
Yeah. But anyway, on the paper, it is possible that somewhere in that book is text. It's also possible that they thought they could get away with this because Donald Trump thinks, I would never ever want to open a book. Why would Lesley Stahl? Let's just give her a blank one. And understand that this is not the first time that they've tried to hoodwink people with fake paper and fake writing. When you know his lungs were falling apart, this was a photo that they sent out of him hard at work, writing in a Sharpie on a blank piece of paper. I guess that was supposed to be impressive. Way back in 2017, he had this tweet, writing my inaugural address at the Winter White House. People have done photos of that desk in front of that wall. It's just in some random hallway. They just did that as a photo shoot. He's not actually writing the speech. He doesn't write his speech. Stephen Miller writes his speeches. Not to mention the financial disclosure papers, all those binders when he was inaugurated that they wouldn't let reporters actually look at, or the fake regulation tower that they made. They have no respect for ink on paper. They like the paper, the ink they want to leave out of it though.
You know, but it really just boils down to the fact that he's been able to get away with this type of stuff throughout his entire career. And he thinks that this is something that he can get away with as president. But it really speaks to the fact that he has lived a life so privileged that he has not ever been held accountable. He can bluff and no one has ever called him on his bluff. But this is a whole different ballgame that he wasn't prepared for.
I think so. Anyway, the whole thing is sad. I haven't, the interview has just been released. CBS, I think it is. Is saying, you know, they're obviously frustrated with him for releasing it. They're still gonna release theirs and it's gonna get so many more views than it would have. And he's obviously not gonna look good in it. Great idea, Trump. Amazing strategy there. So we'll see if, you know, more details come out from it. This is what I was able to see so far. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.